So, hello from St Clare's Hospice. I'm Anne, the new chaplain here, and we just feel it's so important to give ourselves time and a safe place to reflect and remember loved ones. So we're going to record a service from the sanctuary today, and I'd love to hear your comments, whether you would like it to be more interactive. With technology today, we could invite you in. So let me know your comments. Obviously, you can see from the dog collar, I'm a Christian minister, but we are here for people of all faiths and none. So I hope that nothing I say or do today will offend. Please just join in and receive what you can from this. But most important, take time to reflect. So I'm going to start with a prayer. God, we come to you now. We give to you all that we are, all that we're feeling, and all that we think, and ask that you would bring comfort and peace. Amen. So we'll start with a familiar hymn, Morning Has Broken, sung by Cat Stevens.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rain's new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
such a familiar hymn. Let's pray for our world. We pray for our world. We give thanks for the beauty of creation we see. We give you our distress at the destruction and disease that we also see. And we ask God for a restoration. Bring healing and wholeness to our world. Amen. We pray for our leaders around the world, for wisdom in their decisions, for compassion and courage as they lead us through this pandemic. We pray for scientists around the world, working to advise governments, searching for treatments and vaccine. Help them collaborate and share their wisdom. Amen. We pray for our communities as they help stop the spread of coronavirus. We pray for those who are lonely, for the bereaved, for families and the frontline workers. Lord, you know the challenges each one faces. Will you be present with them, bringing comfort, strength, and hope? Amen. And Denise is going to read a prayer of blessing for healthcare workers. Thank you.
I'm going to read a blessing for healthcare workers written by John O'Donoghue. In this fragile frontier place, your kindness becomes the light that consoles the brokenhearted, awakens with desperate storms the oasis of serenity that calls the spirit to rise from beneath the weight of pain, to create a new space in person's mind where they gain distance from their suffering and begin to see the invitation to integrate and transform it. May you embrace the beauty in what you do and how you stand like a secret angel between the bleak despair of illness and the unquenchable light of spirit that can turn the darkest destiny towards dawn.
Thank you, Denise. So possibly you've tuned in to this video because you have lost a loved one. People are so different, aren't they? Somebody mentioned the other day that we're in the same storm, but we're each in our own boat. So people will be affected differently. It may be that loss is very raw and it's been very recent. Or it may be that years have gone by, but the loss and the sense of pain is still there. We're all different. People can describe the way we go through grief, the numbness and the anger and the sadness. But actually, it's not a process that goes from A to B. It's we dip in and out. So one day we may be feeling fine, and another day we get overwhelmed with emotion. It could be just a picture or a word that brings back memories and leaves us feeling overwhelmed and distressed. So just want to assure you that whatever you're feeling, it's okay. But as we do journey through grief, there will be days where life is foggy. You can't see ahead of you. You can't see the way. You don't know where you are. You don't know what you're thinking or feeling, and you don't know the way out. So just rest and know that that's perfectly normal, and it will pass. It may come back, but it's not continuous. So just rest in it and enjoy the good memories that you have and be gentle on yourself. Don't think you've got to do anything. Relax. And there'll be other days where you're just overwhelmed with beauty or good memories, maybe those holidays, maybe a scene will come to mind and you'll just notice the beauty, maybe of nature, of a relationship, maybe looking into the eyes of somebody in your family. And that's great too, isn't it? Just to take time to think and give thanks for the beauty and the good times and the good feelings. Because if you've lived and loved someone, there will be a treasure store of good memories. And as we come out of the fog, sometimes we're struck by the beauty and the delight of the life that we've had together with that person we've lost. And other days, we actually see a path, and it's a path where we take one step at a time towards a new reality. You'll never lose the love and the pain of losing a loved one, but you will learn to live differently. For those that have lost a partner, that's very hard, isn't it? It's like losing half of you and everything from the moment you wake up in the morning to the moment you go to bed at night will be different. But as you begin to tread that new path, it will get easier. Not less painful, unfortunately, but the regular, the daily routines will become more natural. And remember, wherever you are, in the fog, delighting in the beauty, or making those tentative steps on along a new path, remember that you're not alone. There are so many going through this journey. Perhaps not your unique journey, but they are journeying as you are. And as a Christian, I really believe that God knows you, accepts you, and wants to walk with you. So now we're going to take time to remember for ourselves those people we've loved. So if you'd like to light a candle or get out a photograph, whatever you want to do, well, let's just take time now to remember those that we love.
So as we come to this time to remember, perhaps you've got your candle ready and you'd like to light it now. We're going to listen to some music and pray. Lord, as I light this candle, I want to have time to remember and to honour and spend time to reflect. Amen.
Thank you. The Bend in the Path by Stephen Brown. We are all on a journey, a trek here on earth. We are all on a path that started with birth. Our paths are connected, our paths are apart. Our paths are lit with sunshine, and at times in the dark. Some paths are long and narrow, others short, winding ways. At times the rocks and the hills go on endless for days. There are things that lay waiting. There are twists, turns and strife. And who knows what lies round the bend of our life. No matter the place on your path you may be, there is a guide who will lead. He is with you, you see. He knows all our paths from beginning to end. He is the one who sees what lies round the bend. So why would we travel without the help of our guide, when he is so willing to walk by our side?
On the planet and blinking, step into the sun. There's more to be seen than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. Some say I'll be eaten, some say live and let live. But all I agree is to join the stampede. You should never take more than you give. In the circle of life is the wheel of fortune. It's the leap by faith. We'll be right back.
and a blessing. May the sun bring you new energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worries. May the breeze blow new strength into your being. May you walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of your life. Amen.